Good morning, guys. Welcome to the Wicked Sheets Facebook Live video. Thank you guys so much for watching the last couple of Facebook Live videos. We've had so much success. We wanted to switch it up this morning, and so we have a guest with us, Dr. Kevin Chapman, a clinical psychologist here in Louisville, Kentucky, who specializes in anxiety and other disorders and uses cognitive behavioral therapy as a treatment. So one of the most important reasons why we like to meet with Dr. K-Chap is because he knows a lot about his patients and that anxiety can create other issues related to sleep and other disruptions at nighttime. So, of course, with night sweats and hot flashes, our business, we want to be a resource for our customers. And a lot of our customers tell us that because they have night sweats, you know, it's not always just a medication or a condition. They're also dealing with some anxiety. So if you might just tell us a little bit about what anxiety is and what it looks like, I think that'll be really good for our customers and offer some other perspective for us.
Certainly. So anxiety is rarely a problem. It's a normal, adaptive, healthy emotional experience. And anxiety always has three parts. There's the cognition or the thoughts of uncontrollability or unpredictability of something that might happen. So it's always a what if involved in anxiety. There's also the physiological part of anxiety, which is where night sweats are relevant. So Sweating, of course, is a symptom of anxiety, but so is things like heart palpitations, heart racing, shortness of breath, lightheadedness, dizziness, stomach distress, those sorts of things. And then behaviors. So behaviors, of course, with anxiety are things like a tendency toward wanting to escape or avoid and get out of the situation. So, of course, anxiety is rarely a problem when it's kept in check, but oftentimes it's chronic. So when it's chronic, things like sweating can be really profuse and can be very uncomfortable for the person and cause problems like night sweats.
Yeah, so I think what a lot of the misnomer is in anxiety is that folks think they can just experience it during the day in a situation, you know, with a spider or a flight or something like that. I think a lot of folks don't realize that it can wake you up at night. And that's something that I guess we refer to more as a panic attack, right? Mm-hmm. So can you tell me a little bit more about nocturnal panic attacks?
Absolutely. So a nocturnal panic attack is when anxiety is priming the pump for panic. Panic always occurs as a result of chronic anxiety. You rarely will ever panic without anxiety being present first. So a nocturnal panic attack is when you have a sudden rush of intense fear, discomfort that occurs at night, and it has symptoms of heart palpitations, shortness of breath, extremely intense symptoms that occur, but it's at nighttime. And when you have a panic attack, it's literally the fear response. Mm-hmm. It's just a false alarm. So in other words, I'm telling my body that I'm in danger or that something threatening is happening, when in reality, it's a false alarm. Fear, on the other hand, is a true alarm. So basically, panic is comprised of the fear response gone wrong, so to speak.
Sure.
And nocturnal panic occurs at night and usually wakes the person up. And you can imagine how scared that individual could be as a result.
Absolutely. So a few weeks ago, we did our other Facebook Live video on tips of dealing with night sweats. And I touched just briefly on, you know, making sure you have water next to the bed. And for us, we always do like the external, the tangible. Mm-hmm. I said, you know, not putting lotion on your skin, clogging those pores. What could we suggest to our viewers and to our customers that might help them deal with night sweats during a nocturnal panic attack, or if you wake up in a panic attack?
Well, I think it's interesting because in some sense, you can be very preventative. A lot of people who have panic attacks at night, of course, it's very subjective and they feel like they're a victim because they are, unless they understand the relationship between their thoughts, their physiological arousal, such as sweating at night, mm-hmm. and their behavior. So I'm always about preventative, of course, at first. And I think one piece of that is just having really good sleep hygiene.
Perfect.
Being able to understand the role that your thoughts play in creating the anxiety that primes the pump for the panic later that night is really important. So understanding that the things you do during the day, like winding down a couple hours before you go to sleep, is really important so that you're not hyper aroused.
Right.
Cognitive activity, thinking like, well, what if I do this tomorrow? What if this happens? What if that happens? Calming that down before the train leaves the station, so to speak, is super important. So I think having really good sleep hygiene, turning off screens and machines and such at night before you go to sleep is really important. So really getting your body into a relaxed state that's conducive to sleep, that's super important. I think another tip I would suggest would be something I call anchoring. One important process is being present focused. It's really a mindfulness-based strategy. So being able to take deep breaths. But when I say deep breaths, I mean really inhaling through your nose for 4 to 5 seconds and then exhaling slowly for about 6 seconds. That's a physiological reset button. Right? It's like pressing the easy button at Staples.
Mm-hmm.
So once you do that, then you're able to really process your five senses, just thinking about the sounds going on around you. I'm laying in my bed. I feel my pillow. I smell X, Y, and Z. Like, that's a really important process to get in the habit of doing. But I would practice doing that at least once a day, mm-hmm. even when you don't need to, so that you can form the habit of doing that at night when it's really important, when you might have something like night sweats. And then I think finally is understanding the role your thoughts play in creating that distress. Like, if you think about it, many people who have panic at night and who have night sweats, oftentimes it's almost predictable to some degree,
sure.
because it's so consistent. So I think one process is really thinking about, what role do my thoughts play? Am I making negative predictions? Am I saying, I know it's going to happen again? Well, that creates distress in your body, and your body hears Jaws music, so to speak, and prepares you to have night sweats or prepares you to panic. So understanding the role your cognitions or thoughts play in creating the arousal associated with anxiety and panic is extremely important, because that'll definitely downregulate you and allow you to have a relaxed night of sleep.
Wow, that is super informative. And the anchoring component is something that I know I've practiced. Mm-hmm. I'm not the biggest fan of flying. Yeah, I think all healthy individuals do, right? Not the biggest fan of flying. And I know a lot of times I've practiced by saying, all right, this is where I am here and now. And just bringing my mind to that present state was so helpful. And you know, I've dealt with night sweats my whole life mm-hmm. for various reasons. I know with a lot of my friends right now, school is back in session. They can't turn their minds off, things like that. So I just think it's really important for our customers, especially those that we hear from all the time, to understand that anxiety can be a huge component in your night sweats. It might be, you know, as a result of menopause or hormones or whatever, but a lot of those comorbidities, if you... if that's occurring in your life, then to be aware of that and to have the tools and resources to cope with it is really helpful. You know, we know that Wicked Sheets are great, but we want to make sure that everybody has other solutions and things to turn to. So I just want to say thank you so much for watching, and thanks, Dr. Kevin K-Chap, my dear friend, for helping us. And hopefully our customers have learned a little bit more about how to cope with night sweats. Thanks, guys.